What's up everyone, Howard Pinsky here with a brand new Lightroom tutorial. I haven't done one of these in a while, but when I saw the new boundary warp feature, I just had to jump in and I had to record a new video for you guys. And if you haven't been keeping up to date, as of a few updates ago, you can now process HDR and panoramas directly within Lightroom without having to go back into Photoshop. And in this latest update, we have a new boundary warp feature within panorama processing. So let me go ahead and show you how that works. So I have here two sets of panoramas. The first one is one I took in Niagara Falls, and I'm gonna simply click on the first image, hold down my shift key and click on the last one, and then right click on any of them, go down to photo merge and choose panorama. And at this point, Lightroom is going through, taking all the images and stitching them together as seamlessly as possible, and it's going to give us a preview in just about there it is. So now we have our panorama, it's nicely stitched together, but as you can see around the edges, we have this transparent area, or in this case, it's kind of white. And there are a few different options that you have. You could take this photo, bring it into Photoshop, use some content-aware fill magic, which isn't always perfect, but it does a pretty good job. Or you can auto-crop it, which kind of removes a lot of the photo, which some people may not want. Now, in this case, the details around the edges aren't very exciting, but in your photos, you may have some features around the edges that you may want to keep, and auto-cropping it or just cropping it in general may get rid of those features. But now in the latest version of Lightroom, we have a boundary warp feature. And you're gonna notice when I start to drag this to the right, it's going to warp the edges and keep those details in the photo. So let me go back and show you again. You're gonna notice I'm gonna drag it to the right. It's not cropping anything. It's simply warping the edges and keeping the detail. And what's really cool is there's very little distortion. Usually when you start warping things, things become very distorted. But in this case, let me do it again. I'm gonna go all the way to the left, and then all the way to the right, you are noticing in the middle, in this piece of land, there's a tiny little bit of distortion. Again, all the way to the left and all the way to the right, but it's very minimal and you're really not going to notice it. And I've been able to keep all the details around the edges of this panorama. So at this point, I'm able to press the merge button. Lightroom's gonna do its thing, create the panorama, stitch it together, warp those boundaries, and in just a few seconds, it's going to give me that final image, and there it is. Now at this point, I can press the D key on my keyboard to hop into my develop module, where I can start to make some changes. In this case, I may want to bring down the highlights to bring out some of the sky, increase the clarity a little bit. And you know what? In this case, the new dehaze adjustment may actually work quite well. So I'm going to scroll all the way to the bottom, increase dehaze. Ooh, look at that. Now it did increase the saturation and contrast just a little bit. So I'm going to decrease the vibrance just a touch and bring out the shadows a little bit. And that's looking a little bit better. Here's the before and here's the after. Pretty decent. And again, I was able to keep all those details with the new boundary warp slider. So let me press G to go back to my grid view. Let's do one more example. This sequence was shot right here in Colorado. It was actually the trip that convinced me to move out to this beautiful state. So again, I'm gonna go to photo merge, go to panorama. This one will take a little bit longer because there are a few extra photos in this sequence, and I believe I was using a different camera with a few more megapixels, but regardless, here's the panorama all stitched together, and again, I could go ahead and auto-crop it, or bring it into Photoshop and use some content-aware magic, or now I can simply grab my boundary warp slider, drag it over to the right, and I'm able to keep all those details without having to go through any additional trouble. So I'm gonna press merge, Lightroom's gonna do its thing and give me my final completed panorama. And just like with the last example, I'm gonna grab the panorama, press the D key on my keyboard. Let's actually go down to the dehaze slider right from the get-go. I'm gonna increase a little bit, scroll back up to the top, decrease my highlights a touch, increase the shadows, the clarity a little bit. That's looking pretty decent. Maybe the contrast a touch. Exposure is looking pretty good, and I'm pretty happy with that result. Here's the before, and here's the after. And one more time, all the details around the edges, even though they're not very exciting, have been kept in place. And I have seen boundary warp used on panoramas that contain people around the edges, and it did a surprisingly good job in not distorting them. And that'll do it, the new boundary warp feature within the latest version of Lightroom CC. Thanks so much for watching, guys. If you want to learn more about Lightroom or Photoshop or pretty much any other application your heart desires, head on over to lynda.com/Howard. You guys can sign up for 10 days completely free. And if you decide to stick around after that, it'll not only help you, but it'll also help me as well. So thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in my next video. Take care.